What's going on is we are standing outside to make sure that patients have safe access to our health centers. There's a press conference happening that is about a lawsuit that was filed against the city of Chicago about the bubble zone ordinance. And we feel strongly that the bubble zone is something that's really important and our patients should be able to access healthcare safely without being harassed. There's a long history of violence towards health centers and staff and even patients being harassed trying to enter health centers throughout the country, and it's important to have this bubble zone intact so patients are able to get the care they need without feeling shamed. Planned Parenthood provides expert reproductive health care, whether it is birth control, STI screenings, cancer tests, variety of services, and whether you're coming here for one service or the other, you could potentially be harassed while you're walking into a health center, and the bubble zone protects a patient's rights while also protecting the protesters' freedom of speech, because there's an 8-foot zone around a patient that is plenty of space for a protester to get their message across and still have the patient be safe and not harassed.
Today, the Thomas More Society filed a federal lawsuit against the city of Chicago over its abortion clinic bubble zone.
I'm Ann Scheidler, Vice President of the Pro-Life Action League, and I've been a sidewalk counselor here in Chicago for the last 40 years. The Chicago City Council passed its bubble zone ordinance in October 2009. There was absolutely no need to restrict the activities of sidewalk counselors trying to offer abortion alternatives to women in Chicago. There was no provocation for the introduction of the changes in the disorderly conduct ordinance. The bubble zone ordinance accomplished nothing other than depriving pregnant women of the vital information they needed in order to make informed decisions about the fate of their unborn babies. Where peaceful pro-lifers are simply trying to exercise their First Amendment right to free speech and free assembly.
My hope as a sidewalk counselor is to give hope and help to women and men considering abortion. Many parents are just unaware of all the good support available for themselves and their babies. So I ask your help, I ask your prayer, please stop the bubble law and refresh freedom of speech to all. Thank you.